Hello friends, today is the second episode, you can say, of my repotting of plants, and today I have chosen three cacti to repot. So this is one of it. This is a very special and a rare plant. Its name is Euphorbia nova somalia. This is another one that I have picked for repotting. It is a Macmillaria. Okay, and the third one that I have picked is a Indian Concorb. This is the one. They are all shaky and they are all falling because of my dog who keeps roaming about and throws them down. Their soil has really gone down because every time they fall, it just spills on the floor and I have to repot them. So let us start with the process. These are the pots that I have picked for repotting. It has about 5 holes, actually doesn't require so many holes, but then yes, I have got them drilled to these pots, and these are the ones that I'm going to use for repotting. Since the soil mixture is very grainy, we have to keep something to prevent it from draining out from these holes. So I have kept pieces of
jute.
And so let us go on with the soil mixture. Here I have taken 45% of river sand, which is not strained, so the stones are still there. 45% of garden soil, and the remaining 10% it's a perlite that I have used. So here is the mixture of the entire 3 ingredients. And here let us start with repotting. The first one that I have chosen is this variety of Euphorbia nova somalia, which is a rare plant, very lucky to have it. So here I am removing it from this old pot, and if you see, it hardly has any soil because it has fallen a number of times, it has broken and it has got hurt, and every time it gets hurt you get this white milky substance that comes out from this cactus. So here I am planting it. Let me tell you something about this plant. This Euphorbia is a plant that flowers, and it requires direct sunlight. It requires to be watered when the soil dries up. So you want the soil to dry up between watering. So when it is completely dried, watering should be taken into consideration. It is found that when these flowers happen to this plant, pruning would be the best thing to be done to it so that it continuously flowers. My plant is a young plant, so I have to wait a lot of time to flower it. So let us proceed with planting the Indian Concorb. Again, this plant has fallen a number of times, and also a plant that I have not seen in many nurseries, so I am assuming it is not easily available in a place where I stay. Taking care of it is the same. Direct sunlight has to be watered only when the sun only when the water dries up. And let us go on to the last one, which was flowering in my garden, but then it has fallen again and again. So, and it has smashed, the topmost part of it also has smashed because it has fallen down. This is a Macmillaria cactus. I could propagate it by just taking a piece off from there, but I do not want to do that. Let it get settled, let it give me more flowers, and then I could proceed with the same. Using the same procedure, I am potting it. I've never tried about fertilizing cacti, but in what I have read, it's to understand that you do not require to fertilize cacti. But if you do have that intention, maybe once a year, you could dilute your organic fertilizer in water and utilize it for fertilizing. Now again, when we are watering, you know the amount of water we put for these plants. It is just a sprinkle. So even if you're diluting your fertilizer, it's not going to have that much of an impact. So you can go ahead and fertilize your cacti once a year. See how I am watering it. I am like just giving a sprinkle, and I'm really stingy about giving water to my cacti. So this is all, friends. I hope you enjoyed this video on repotting of cacti. Thank you so much for watching. I see you again in the next.